Hello. Just a moment. Damn housekeeping. Smoking my Soren Rushbjerg Rasmussen pipe. My Soren pipe. Or as I can say, because I'm Danish, Søren Rushbjerg Rasmussen. Yeah. Take that. Oh yeah, and smoking some Cillamans Black that I got from Pop Scratch. The reason for this video is actually today, February the 8th, is exactly 1 year ago from my first video. It was 1 year ago on this day. And I owe is a special someone a lot of thanks for helping me with getting my YouTube channel. And that is let's say here, Jens. Hello, Jens. He stay actually. Let's see, Jens and Pipe Poet were here a year ago, and at some point, Pipe Poet had to go, but Let's see, Jens stayed a little while longer, and he helped me with hooking up with my YouTube channel, which I've had ever since. Well, at least one of them. And I'm still not sure if I still have two, but one of them is, and that this is this one. So it says up here, it's the Rolfeden, the Rolfeden. But I have maybe another one called Mr. Rolfeden, or that maybe that one was the first one, I don't know. Well, this is not just about it being a year from a year that I've been on YouTube. So this about your alternate persona. My alternate persona would be a tall, thin, gentleman about my age, but it would be another time. It would have been like in the, I would say, the 1880s. I would be, I don't know, rich, but I wouldn't be super rich, but I would be doing okay, enough to could get bread on and food on the table, and enough to indulge in cultural activities, so such as going to the theater and opera and ballet and concert, and of course enjoying the arts and the pleasure of smoking a pipe. And since this is fiction, I would say maybe one of my near friends was a certain Holmes, Sherlock Holmes, and Dr. Watson. Of course, my profession wouldn't be anything involved with crime whatsoever. It would be something more peaceful, but you know. And I would have a butler. It kind of be like Jeeves and Wooster, if anyone knows that series. Okay, that maybe makes me be a bit more well off than just average. Another thing, and that's to you, Jay and Jason. Great pipes, that those two merchant pipes. Was that yours, Jason? Was that from a drawing of yourself with the cap and your beard and the pipe? It looks that way. What else? Oh yeah, and congrats to Pipe Lawyer on your new purchase. You also always seems to get these good-looking big pipes. And Glenn, GLO 0115. All I can say, I'm glad I'm not living in England, or I'm going to. We do have some restrictions here in Denmark. You're not allowed to smoke, I guess, indoors at public places, indoors, unless the place you are smoking have a certain size. In this term, it's like small size. There are exceptions. I mean, the place where Pipe Scratch and me we meet when we meet is a pub, an Irish pub, or Irish, it's like, you know, like a kind of pub. I mean, but it actually is employed with real Irish people, and there's always, I guess, English or Irish football in the background and Irish music. So, and you drink Murphy's, and you drink Guinness, of course, and you drink Kilkenny and all that stuff. And you, if you drink whiskey, you drink Bushmills, of course. That is one of the few places where you can smoke inside these days. And there is the place in the cellar at the Paul Olsen slash Davidoff place that you may or may not have seen in a video that Pipe Scratch made, what seems now to be a long time ago. I think it was in December 2010 at some point. There'd be some complications on that place because of the weather. The summer last year, it flooded, and they're still repairing the cellar. But It should be finished at the end of this month, so we're looking very much forward to that. But it's a much more cozy place. The music is not so loud, and it's more warm. So that will be fantastic. I'm looking very much forward to that. And that's also one of the places me and Pipe Scratch and me are going to show you, that being you, Jay and Jason, when you come this summer. It's a really cool place. And if it's continues as it did last year, for that, every Friday, you pay 50 Danish crowns. I don't know what that is in dollars, and then you can taste a lot of different tobacco tins with mixtures, and you can pull yourself a whiskey or a glass of rum or cognac or that kind of stuff also. That's a great place for us smokers or and of course the other place we have say we have two places in Copenhagen that I know of. Where you can that's specialized in tobacco and pipes and cigars and stuff. Paul Olsen slash Davidoff in one, and the other one is the Danish Pipe Shop. And that place is, as I said, it's one of those places that have this the exact size that means that you can smoke inside. It just mean it means it's very small. Doesn't it's okay. The only downside of that place is as you cannot sit down, you have to stand up. And that's the good thing about the cellar at Paul Olsen slash Davidoff. You can sit down in good chairs and stuff, you know. Which, if you want to smoke for a longer time, this is better, I guess. But I mean, both places are good in their own rights. Yeah. I basically think this is it for now. Bringing her out. We may just finish off with some shout outs. Shout out to Briar Ambition, Yorkshire Pipins. Pipe Lounge, Mollifant, Jake Hackett, of course. The Pipe Greek. I don't know if you're still around, but if you are, heyo. Dunhill Man UK. She's a good girl, and she is. Godfrey the Giant and HARJOERIC. And East End Hawaii Pipes. East End Pipes, yeah. And Larger Man's and Patrick the Pipe. Double the Dam. Pipehead Odor. DIGHSX. Okay, Gulong. Beans 316. Samurai Pirates 88. One Man Smoke. Here comes Charlie, Dagny performance, of course, and the visual stenographer. And by the way, I'm still enjoying my BP jump pipe. I'm probably the only one that has a BP jump pipe in Denmark, I'm pretty sure. I don't know if I've mentioned it, but well, pipe scratch and me, we visited a pipe maker that was Søren Rifbjerg Rasmussen, and I bought this one, and pipe scratch bought another one, and what's up with that? No, anyway. Yeah. Well, anyway. I'll finish off like I always do. The saying, until next time.